Here tonight, another epic episode of Thailand versus the Philippines.
That's right, Chris. Both these fighters feel they deserve another shot at the belt, and one minor mistake was all it took to cost them the strap. And now is their shot to get it back into the title hunt.
Paccio going with the high point kick. Anoy Sirichok stalking forward. Paccio moving backwards. Sirichok with a switch kick, blocked by Paccio.
Typically, we see Crew Wrong, which is Anoy Sirichok's nickname. We see him start a little bit slower, but he's actually really trying to put the pressure on Paccio, and he's starting a lot faster than he usually does.
And as we see him close down the distance, it would seem to be to the avoidance of the movement skills and speed of Paccio. Big kick again there from Anoy Sirichok. Paccio presses the clinch.
When you fought Muay Thai over 350 times at the absolute highest level, you have a skill set on your feet that is incomparable to anybody out there. You gotta wonder when Paccio is gonna try to take this to the ground, because you can see him try an outside trip there, but Dej has got just such a strong base, and he just really stops. He's really so strong in the clinch, but he's gotta try to swim underneath Paccio. Ah. Paccio was able to get the double underhooks, use that to get this fight to the ground.
Paccio using those deep underhooks, as Mitch explained there, to destabilize Anoy Sirichok. And here with plenty of time on the clock, Mitch, Paccio probably where he wanted this one from the beginning.
Yeah, that's exactly where he wants to be. He wants to be on top, have Anoy Sirichok on the bottom, and just tire him out. Utilize those body shots like he's doing right now to slowly start to watch Anoy Sirichok fade. But it's just not gonna happen. And it's only a three-round fight. We didn't see Anoy Sirichok start to fade until like that fourth and fifth round when he fought Naito, because he's got the juice to go all three rounds pretty heavily.
And Anoy Sirichok doing the right thing here to try to pull Paccio down, break his posture, and hand fight a bit, Mitch.
Yeah, he's doing that. He's definitely trying to stop the ground and pound, but he's keeping his guard closed, which just traps Paccio in that ground and pound position. So he's just kind of holding him there to drop these bombs. He's got to let go of the feet and start to scramble and maybe get back up to his feet.
Referee watching very carefully here, and somebody right now, Mitch, needs to work to improve their position, but it's Anoy Sirichok going here to grab the neck.
He's got a guillotine, and the crowd is definitely responding to this packed arena here at Impact Stadium, but I think he's a bit too high. He's only got one hand on it, so he's really just holding the head of Paccio. Paccio's gonna pop his head out like he just did, and really just see how he's just softening up the body, but I like how Anoy Sirichok's throwing elbows from the bottom.
And the name of the game here would be to perhaps force a stand-up.
Ooh, that's what he needed to do. He opened his guard, shrimped out to the side, and started moving away, but Paccio immediately jumped over that and ended the half guard. But we see Paccio, he's really not trying to pass the guard of Anoy Sirichok. He's just able to sit there, and he's content just to beat him up, which is that ground and pound that we spoke about at the beginning of the fight.
And right now, Paccio capitalizing on a momentary lapse of concentration from Anoy Sirichok, sitting here in half. Olivia Coast calling for both fighters to work here, but I feel like the onus is on Paccio right now.
Yeah, definitely. He's definitely scoring a lot of the ground and pound, and he's controlling the top position. Most people believe if you're on top, you're winning the fight, unless you're doing a lot of damage or you're really throwing up a lot of submissions, which Anoy Sirichok is not doing right now. He's just kind of holding on to that half guard, and he's also holding on to the body, which is draining. It's going to take a lot of energy to hold on to somebody as strong as Paccio is and try not to let him go.
And he's certainly trying to protect himself and use that lockdown. As you'll see, he's got the ankle underneath his calf, and of course the other ankle grapevined in, Mitch. He's doing the right thing, but the big question is it enough?
Yeah, he's got the black belt Broginho Issa in his corner right now, shouting out instructions through the translator in the corner there. So Anoy Sirichok has the best vantage point possible, but Paccio was just too much on top. The ground and pound coming from Paccio. Looks like he might have a neck here and a guillotine.
Paccio looking to finish here, holding on to the neck. Just a few seconds left in the round, and the fans cheering for Anoy Sirichok, who has certainly had to weather an early storm as Paccio ends the round on top.
Paccio's threatening that side kick again. Look how fast that kick comes out. No setup whatsoever. He just throws it out there.
Amnoy Sirichok with the punishing counter. And Pascio certainly taking a very quick route on those kicks. Not as much power, Mitch, but certainly quick kicks. Oh,
big leg kick by Amnoy Sirichok. This is where he needs to keep the fight. He needs to keep his distance, but he's consistently moving forward. If Pashiao, yep, caught a kick, picks him up, sends him down with a huge takedown to end up in side control, which is not a good spot for Amnoy Sirichok.
A single kick from Amnoy Sirichok and the penalty, an opportunity for Pascio to take him down and straight into side control. Mitch, that's efficient.
Yeah, I would have thought the corner would have been like, all right, ease up on the leg kicks. Let's throw some hands. Let's keep this fight on the feet. Start moving around. But Pascio caught that leg kick, and now we're back in the same position that we ended the first round in, and there's a lot of time for Pascio to start working.
Pascio working the wrestling department here again in half and utilizing the odd ground and pound to try to open up position and possibly a pass.
Yeah, this is a good position for Pascio. He's really able to do a lot of damage. We've got 3.5 minutes left, and this is where Pascio is going to be able to do most of his handiwork. He's just on top, dropping that ground and pound, and that's really been the story of the fight so far in what we're approaching is the first half of the fight.
But he's going to work on that far side arm. Tough to see from our angle here on the monitor. There we go, much better. Possible straight arm bar here.
Yeah, he's got the straight arm bar, but he might transition into a Kimura where Amnoy Sirichok seems to be keeping the arm straight. It's going to be very hard to submit at that position. Amnoy Sirichok just shook it off. He's got to create more scrambles. He's like trying to maybe conserve his energy. But Pascio is really strong on top, so I could be wrong in saying that he's not trying to create scrambles. But Pascio is just controlling and grounding and pounding.
One thing interesting of note here is that Pascio, there we go, that was what I was looking for, was an attempt to try to actively pass and not just use the ground and pound to try to open up a pass. Pressing on the knee, Pascio now trying to force his way into mount, but great defense there from Amnoy Sirichok.
Yeah, he's defending, he's keeping it in half guard, but he's worrying more about the pass, so he's enabling Pascio to drop even more shots into him, and he's controlling, he's got a cradle position. This is Amnoy Sirichok's shot to get back up to his feet.
Oh, Amnoy Sirichok trying to explode. Pascio thinking about the back take here and goes with the body lock.
Amnoy Sirichok gave up his back in the attempt to get back up to his feet. He might get suplexed here, but Pascio transitions to a single leg. Beautiful takedown by Pascio.
Great defense there from Amnoy Sirichok again, but Pascio one step ahead. Gets him down again to the canvas here. Let's see what he can do with it.
I think it's going to be more of the same, Chris. I think he's just comfortable to sit in the half guard and start dropping bombs because I don't think he might try to pass. It looks like he's trying to work the knee up towards the hips of Amnoy Sirichok to maybe pop that knee out through the legs. But it's just, this is where he does his best work. He likes to control the opponents and really just beat him up from the top.
And certainly when you consider the striking skills of Amnoy Sirichok, despite Pascio being proficient in that department, this is probably the path of least resistance.
Yeah, there's very few people in the world that can stand up with him. And actually, there might be a few of them here in the stadium tonight, but because we are in Thailand. But primarily, this is where Pascio wants to keep this fight. He wants to keep it on the ground, keep Amnoy Sirichok back flat against the mat here. And just now he's attempting the Kimura again. It looks like he's trying to attack the far side arm, but Amnoy Sirichok's doing the right thing by keeping his elbows nice and tight, but the crowd is really getting into this little bit of a ground and pound exchange by these two.
And even as Amnoy Sirichok throws short punches and elbows off his back, the crowd cheering every time they land, but Pascio staying busy just enough to keep this one down on the ground.
And that's exactly his game plan. You can hear Mark Sangrillo yelling at him what he wants him to do. And that's gotta be just keep him down, beat him up on the mat, and eventually, when this round ends in about 20 seconds, 10 seconds, they're gonna get another shot on the feet. And you gotta wonder, is Dej's corner gonna be like, all right, no more leg kicks, let's use just the hands and see if we can change the possible destiny of this contest here tonight.
He wants a win.
He's got See, he immediately keeps going. He goes right after the punches, and that needs to be where he needs to go. He needs to throw the hands, stay away from the takedown, be careful with his kicks, because Pacquiao is snatching those kicks up very quickly, and he's able to transition into some big takedowns.
And you're seeing, again, a lot of pressure here from Amnoy Sirichok. Constant forward movement. On the back foot is Pacquiao. Left hand followed by Amnoy Sirichok, and then Pacquiao thinking about the takedown, shrugged off. That's better from Amnoy Sirichok.
Yeah, that's what he wants. He wants to be able to stop the takedown, but I like how he's not throwing any kicks. He's going just after the hands. Nice uppercut there from Pacquiao, though.
Overextension from Amnoy Sirichok. Uppercut counter there from Pacquiao. Man, these are some exchanges, Mitch.
He stopped the takedown, and now we got ourselves a boxing match. So let's see what kind of gas that Pacquiao has as he shoots him for the takedown. Dej is able to stop it. Very good.
Third time again, shut down by Amnoy Sirichok. Pacquiao now for the first time, possibly on the back foot more often than not. Surging in confidence is Amnoy Sirichok. Wow, what an incredible opportunity here for Pacquiao. Can he get him down?
Oh, that was a good shot. He faked the takedown, went right back after it again. Just that constant chain wrestling, going for takedown after takedown. Amnoy Sirichok sprawling heavy, able to stop his third takedown of this round. He's got to turn it on. He's got 3 minutes for the knockout, as Rich Franklin says, might be his only way to win this fight.
Well, the reshot there from Pacquiao was impressive indeed, but Dej in stalking mode, man. As he goes off the left hand, the crowd really hanging on the edge of their seat here at the Impact Arena. As the TIE fighter connects again with a right hand, Pacquiao in desperation mode, thinking about the double leg, Mitch.
He's got him up against the cage. This might be a chance for him to gather his wits, because it looked like Dej Demeron connected with some big shots there.
Pacquiao trying to get those hands together. Amnoy Sirichok able to keep his hips away and continues to pour on the pressure. The clock is running over the midway point of this round.
Pacquiao looks to be fading a little bit. He looks a little bit tired. His mouth is open as Dej starts to pour it on with a body shot. Goes to the body, goes to the head. Oh, with a big right hand.
Body head from Amnoy Sirichok as he continues to waltz forward and pour on the multiple punch combinations. Pacquiao looks tired, Mitch.
They're giving the crowd exactly what they want, the Philippine versus Thailand striking battle.
And Amnoy Sirichok continues to plod onwards. Out comes the mouthpiece from Pacquiao. Pacquiao looks rocked.
But look at the chin of Pacquiao. He's hanging in there with a Lupini, a three-time Lupini world champion. Shoots it for the takedown. Dej shrugs it off, gets his back.
Amnoy Sirichok looking for the back take. The right hand punches coming in, and he's got the seatbelt, Mitch.
He's got the back. Pacquiao trying to stand up as Dej starts to hammer. It's important to note we are judging the fight on its entirety, not round by round. Big head kick.
Man, what a connection again from the Thai fighter. So much aggression. And certainly plenty of accuracy from Amnoy Sirichok.
I like the uppercut that Pacquiao's throwing because it's landing, but Dej is stalking after the Filipino, throwing heavy hands. They trade push kicks and continue to battle. Finally, Olivier Cost gives Pacquiao his mouthpiece back.
What a fight. What a fight tonight, and the crowd absolutely in so much support for Amnoy Sirichok. Pacquiao struggling to put things together. Can he turn it around, Mitch?
This is very close. He's doing a lot of good, but Pacquiao is really hanging in there. He looks a little bit tired, but he's still answering right back, and he's also landing strikes. Dej just is moving forward, and he's got the crowd on his side, but Pacquiao is right in there still.
And it's a sprint to the finish line as Amnoy Sirichok rips to the legs with the kicks. Pacquiao looking for something here. Amnoy Sirichok, a swing and a miss. 10-second clapper's gone.
Pacquiao is doing good. He's standing there. He got caught with a leg kick. I would like to see him catch it going for the takedown. That could have been the punctuation mark he needed. But a body kick to end the round. What a fight, Chris.
What a performance from Amnoy Sirichok in the third round. So impressive to take the TIE fighter out of his game. Mitch, that was full fat action for 5 minutes.
This was a very impressive part of the story for me. Hear how he's able to push the head down, stop three takedown attempts very effectively to keep this fight on the feet. He stopped with the kicks, went after the hands, and there's a big right hand from Pacquiao.
Your winner by way of split decision from the blue corner, Joshua Pacquiao!